February the 27th, today's wisdom. Beware of pride. Let another man praise thee, and not thine own mouth. A stranger, and not thine own lips. Proverbs 27:2. In this verse, which is linked to the preceding one, Proverbs 27:1, the wise gives us a strong recommendation about pride. To resist every form of self-worship or glorification. Pride is the fact to always highlight our own merits. Pride is a kind of subtle idolatry, the cult of personality. Pride people are under the influence of an advanced spirit of competition. It means that these people suffer from a severe identity crisis. Three things characterize the pride. 1. Everything they do aims at drawing the attention of others. 2. They use others to achieve their goals. 3. Their projects are more valuable to them than individuals. And B. When our education is exclusively based on reward and punishment, we forge in the child a competitive personality, which he will have difficulty to abandon later. Pride doesn't come from anywhere. A success, an exploit, a blessing can easily and subtly activate a seed of pride in our heart. Behind pride is hidden a big lie: you are God. It means that you can do without men. You have all. People must worship you, submit themselves to you, for they have no choice. The pride man declares loudly that he is the master of his life and brags about tomorrow, which is the proof that he is foolish. In fact, being unable to be a master over his passions, he was, over time, enslaved by them without even noticing. Jesus Christ, a perfect example, says, "If I honor myself, my honor is nothing. It is my Father that honors me, of whom ye say that he is your God." John 8:54. Jesus made this declaration as he was harassed by the Jews over his identity. Through this declaration, Jesus wanted to make the Jews realize that only God the Father knows him and testifies of who he is. Truth. Jesus doesn't do or say anything for his own glory, but only for the glory of the Father. Application. To do everything for the glory of the Father. Warning. And whatsoever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Colossians 3:17. Let's pray together. Father, your grace is enough for me. Keep me away from pride. In Jesus' name, amen. Today's reading, Psalm 141-135, Proverbs 27, Deuteronomy 16-18. You are blessed.